Hello and welcome to History by Hollywood, a podcast series that examines the real events and people behind fact-based movies. This is not an episode. This is a public service announcement, as we have some information to impart to all of you, dear listeners. First of all, before I get to the news, I have to give a massive HBH thank you and shout out to Mark Dupre. Not only is Mark our resident film professor, but he's also a very accomplished pianist, and what you've just heard is his version of our theme tune, The Waltz of Anachronism. This is our theme tune composed, of course, by our dear friend Jules Cheesek. Now all we need is the theremin version, and our world will be complete. But thank you, Mark, and this theme will be heard regularly in the future. The reason is today's update. And this is just really a way of reaching more of you lovely people than the website, Facebook and Twitter will allow, because obviously not everybody, you know, uses Facebook and Twitter or look at the website regularly. We are very aware that, as we warned a few weeks ago, the output has become somewhat erratic in recent weeks. And this is likely to continue, although we have arranged more guest hosts, as can be seen on the episodes page of the website at historybyhollywood.com. That's also the homepage. To try and bring you more content, I'm going to start putting out irregular and possibly infrequent companion episodes under the general banner of thoughts and themes. What I'll be doing is re-examining some previous episodes that are either connected by themes or have similar messages, or maybe contrasting messages, but in the same area of interest. The first episode should be out the week after The Highwayman. Now that is planned to push for a week's time. That's Sunday the 19th of July. The first episode of Thoughts and Themes will compare our very first episode, Gladiator, to our 45th, Braveheart, which of course was the movie that inspired the entire idea of this podcast series. Also into the debate will probably come 300 and Kingdom of Heaven. So a subtitle might be Swords and Sandals, although that always makes people think of deserts, Romans or Crusades, and Braveheart, it'd be more Muddy Boots. What it will really be is an opportunity for me to just talk endlessly to a captive audience. I won't even know if you've turned off and thought, yeah, I won't be listening to this again. But through the lens of time and exposure to lots of other movies and lots of thoughts about them, clearly when we record an episode, it's generally, we've seen the movie quite recently, we've done the research quite recently, we record, we put it out. I do listen back, and quite often I'm immediately within a week thinking, oh, I wish I'd said this, I wish I'd said that. We do write notes, but we don't completely stick to a script, as you can probably tell at times. So there have been some further changes to the planned episodes page, also the homepage, as we said, on the website. Largely, this has been made necessary. Andrew, bless him, when half the world is not being able to work at the moment, his workload has gone completely manic. And he's experiencing something that I think a lot of people are finding when they're working from home. You don't have that, right everyone, 5 o'clock, pack up your laptops and we'll see you tomorrow. There's no defined cutoff. And he's finding he's ending up working into the evenings, working at weekends, because there's something bugging at him, like, well, I need to get this bit done. He's doing an awful lot of research. So Andrew's life has been taken over. So we are going to try and bring in some guest hosts, because although I'm still working full time, I'm very fortunate to be able to do so. I am finding myself with a fair amount of spare time. So in the upcoming episodes, and I suppose I should really quickly run through what we have coming up. We've got The Highwayman next week. Hopefully a week after that, Thoughts and Themes. A week after that, or probably 2 weeks, we will be welcoming back Des Latham. Now, Des, as you know, has been on a couple of times to talk about Breaker Morant and Zulu Dawn. Des, the host of the Anglo-Boer War podcast, which is sadly finished now. Now, Des has recently started the Battle of Stalingrad. The episode 3 is available on iTunes. There were some technical hitches getting iTunes to accept and publish. So I believe you may need to go to SoundCloud or another outlet to listen to the first 2 episodes. But they're very good. It's Des's storyteller's style, but with, again, just like the Anglo-Boer War, impeccable research. But what Des also has been running for a while is the plane crash diaries. Like me, but in a different area of aviation, Des is a professional pilot. So he and I are going to get together and we're going to look at Sully. This stars Tom Hanks as Captain Sullivan, who was the pilot of a small airliner that ditched into the Hudson Bay. People might remember this a few years ago. And we'll be looking at both the real events and the movie and the portrayal of those. After that, hopefully no more than a fortnight, we will be doing Midway, which has been on the schedule for a while. But again, to alleviate Andrew's research, we're bringing in Ray Harris, the host of History of World War II podcast. Ray's joined us before for Battle of Britain and for The Darkest Hour. So now, and I do know that Ray is a real has a real focus of expertise on the Pacific War. So, and it is a good film. If you haven't seen it, yeah, okay, the action sequences are a bit from a galaxy far, far away. I think that's a joke I've already made before, but it's good and it's quite balanced, and there's a lot of small historical details that from first view I would say they've got right. So we'll go into that. Probably just after that we will go to Thoughts and Themes 2. Now this is going to be quite topical because we'll be talking about the matter of race relations. In the midst of the Black Lives Matter movement gaining global momentum, we're going to concentrate on a trilogy of movies that we've covered before. Episode 19, Glory. Episode 17, Selma. And we were aware at the time we kind of should have done those the other way around. And then episode 19, Hidden Figures. And we'll look at how they deal with the issue of racial equality or inequality. Here Come the Girls, and this is not to dilute the importance of films with a female focus, but we are going to combine them into a big monster episode. Battle of the Sexes portrays the events of a 1973 one-off tennis match between former world number one Bobby Riggs and Billie Jean King, who was then the leading female player and a real trailblazer for women's tennis. And we'll, following that, If the Battle of the Sexes runs to a very long episode, we might put them out as two separate, but like a week apart. We'll be looking at A League of Their Own. And I do have to apologise to Gary Chavit because he really doesn't like watching Madonna. Although I haven't seen the movie yet, I'm told she's actually very good in it. Following that, and we're really excited about this one, we're going to be covering Gorillas in the Mist. Again, I haven't seen this film for years, and I struggle to remember the detail, but I do remember it's not a happy movie, but it's a fascinating one. Gorillas in the Mist is the story of Diane Fossey and her work with gorillas in Africa, where she'd been encouraged by Louis Leakey, the anthropologist, to study and see what she could discover about gorilla interactions, how their society worked, would you describe them as having a culture and all this stuff. This is obviously has a quite a deep environmental message or a deep environmental focus. So we're going to be doing a joint episode with the green screen team. That's not easy to say. The green screen team of Cody Clymer and Sean Munger. So it will be great to have those guys coming to join us. And it will basically be a joint episode for us and themselves. So it might take a slightly different format than one we're used to. After that, Andrew and I will do The Two Popes, which is, again, a very contemporary and topical take on the leadership of the Catholic Church. And then we're going to return on the back of the Thoughts and Themes episode 2 on race relations. We're going to look at Just Mercy. I've not seen it yet. I plan to watch it in the next few days. It gets incredibly good reviews. It's talking about the story of Bryan Stevenson, a brilliant civil rights lawyer working in the US who founded the Equal Justice Initiative, a group that has managed to see at least 170 death row convictions overturned, which is shocking. Not shocking that they're overturning the convictions, shocking that the convictions occurred in the first place. The movie shows his defence of Walter McMillian, a man who'd been convicted of the murder of a young white woman despite a lack of convincing evidence, so we will dive into that. The publication dates where posted are obviously subject to real-life intervention and any unexpected hiccups caused by COVID-19, but That's what we're planning, and we really are enthused to try and keep the quality of our output going. But that does mean that, as we explained last time we talked about this subject, we're having to maybe dial back a little bit on the frequency of episodes being produced. Thank you for your time. We do hope we provide sufficient entertainment and interest to keep you all with us through these challenging times. Do please tell your friends about us, if only just so they can look really geeky when they're watching a film, go, I know what really happened. And we're going to go out with another piece of piano music from Marc Dupré, Professor Marc Dupré. But this is music from a movie, which I must admit, I'd never heard of, but Mark said this was a movie from his youth, and it's some music, it's a beautiful piece of music. So we're just going to play out with it. And the first person who can tell me what film this is from, yeah, just write in, let us know. And if we ever get to a stage of prominence and affluence where we can actually afford any kind of merchandise, we'll send you something. Okay, thank you, folks, and we will speak to you next week with Kevin Costner and Woody Harrelson, who's becoming a mainstay of this show, with The Highwayman. Bye-bye.